This video is on the topic of efficiency. What does it mean to be energy efficient? LED bulbs are more efficient than filament bulbs. That means that the LED bulb requires less energy to produce the same amount of light. But how does it do this? We know that energy is transferred electrically from the main supply to the light bulb. That energy is then transferred away from the light bulb by radiation and by heating to the surroundings. The transfer by radiation or visible light is the useful energy transfer. The purpose of a light bulb is to provide light, but energy is transferred unusefully by heating to the thermal store of the surroundings. We call this wasted energy because it's not part of the intended function of the light bulb. The more wasted energy there is in an energy transfer, the less efficient that energy transfer is. Energy efficiency is a hot topic right now, so it's very likely that you will get asked about it in your exam. Efficiency is just the ratio of the useful energy output to the total energy input. This equation can be used for calculations. You can also use power to calculate efficiency using this equation. These equations will give you a decimal answer between 0 and 1. If you need to convert them to percentages, you can just multiply the decimal by 100. Let's take a look at an example exam question. Which of the following energy transfers is the most efficient? The first thing to do is make sure you're clear about what the question is asking. To find the most efficient energy transfer, we need to identify the transfer with the least wasted energy. You may want to actually make a note of this on your exam paper. Because we have two different values to compare, we need to focus on just one of them. So let's figure out the percentage of wasted energy for all the answer options. If 100% is the total amount of energy being transferred out of the system, and for A, 65% of that is useful, then the remaining 35% is wasted. And for C, 35% is useful, so that leaves 65% wasted. Now we can easily compare all the values of wasted energy. So for A, 35% is wasted. For B, 30% is wasted. For C, 65% is wasted. And for D, 45% is wasted. So the energy transfer with the least amount of wasted energy is 30%, which is B for 1 mark. Remember that you're free to annotate your exam paper in any way that you might find helpful. Here's an example of a calculation question. A wind turbine has an input energy of 5.5 kilojoules per second and an output energy of 2.8 kilojoules per second. Calculate the efficiency of the wind turbine for 3 marks. Notice here that the energy values are given per second. Power is energy transferred per unit time. Therefore, we could use power or energy to calculate efficiency here. So we write out the equation for 1 mark and we substitute in the known values. This is the step that you need to take care with. This is where students often make mistakes. Useful output goes on the top. That's 2,800 joules or 2.8 kilojoules. And the total input goes on the bottom. That's 5,500 joules or 5.5 kilojoules. Because this is a ratio and the units are the same for both values, we don't need to convert them to joules here. But if you do, that's absolutely fine. The correct substitution gets you the second mark. The total energy will always be a large value because energy is conserved and we know that some of the energy transferred will be wasted energy. We want the largest value on the bottom, so always pause to check this. So when we plug that into the calculator and multiply it by 100 to get the percentage, that gives an efficiency of 51% for the final mark. Efficiency calculations tend to be a small part of a larger question, so you will often have to calculate the energy or power value in a previous part of the question. In summary, efficiency is the ratio of the energy usefully transferred and the total energy. It's a way of monitoring wasted energy. Efficiency can be calculated using energy, using power, as a decimal, or as a percentage. And remember that efficiency will usually form just a small part of a larger calculation. So make sure you look in previous question parts for any apparent missing values. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.